There are only very few films that are scheduled to be released in cinemas this year. One of them is Dune. As now reported by Trailer Track, the first trailer for the desert thriller will be shown before the cinema re-release of Inception on the occasion of its 10th anniversary on August 14th, 2020. This is probably intended to lure fans into the cinema, as it is not expected that the trailer will be released online at the same time. After all, Inception will be released in cinemas on different days in different countries. As soon as we have the trailer ready, we will of course notify you. Just activate the bell and stay up to date. The expected release of the movie is at the end of the year on December 18th, 2020. Besides Dune, Warner Brothers plans also the release of Wonder Woman 1984 this year. Also, here the new trailer will be shown before Inception as part of a preview of upcoming Warner movies. Among them could possibly be Tenet and Conjuring 3. In addition, fans of Inception can look forward to a few minutes of bonus material in which Christopher Nolan, among others, will speak to the fans personally. What do you think about the idea of a re-release of Inception? Would the shown trailers be a good incentive for you to go to the cinema, or do you prefer to stream from home? We're excited about your comments. The streaming service Disney Plus can look forward to an addition soon. Mantis, the new Hawkeye series, which was dominated by some rumors in the past days. Among other things, it was reported that Hailee Steinfeld, known from Bumblebee, is the preferred successor of the Marvel Archer. Many fans were pleased with these news, because in the past, fans had already expressed their wish for Steinfeld to play the role of Kate Bishop. As the site The Illuminerd and Marvel insider Jeremy Conrad report, the contract with her is supposed to have been signed already, although great caution is recommended here. The Illuminerd is a relatively new site and hasn't really been able to make a name for itself with exclusive revelations in the past. Also, Conrad is considered controversial since he was often wrong in the past, especially regarding the coverage of Avengers Endgame. As you can see, the situation is anything but transparent at the moment, and you shouldn't trust the rumors that have been well received by the fans 100% at this point in time. It just remains to be seen until we hear something familiar from the official side or well-known industry magazines. The second news about the MCU comes from the Phase 4 movie Thor: Love and Thunder. According to a report by both Slash Film and Natalie Portman personally, the fourth Thor film will be shot by Taika Waititi in early 2021. The actress has revealed this via the Instagram account of her friend Serena Williams. She herself believes that all the delays have given her more time to prepare for the role as Jane Foster. Concerning the plot, Thor: Love and Thunder is supposed to revolve around a romantic but also wacky storyline, as the name suggests. Portman's character, Jane Foster, is supposed to be more in the center of attention, and with Christian Bale there is also a new villain to look forward to. Furthermore, the popular Guardians are also supposed to make an appearance in the new Thor movie. Their current release date for Thor: Love and Thunder is February 11th, 2022. As Warner Brothers reported a few days ago, the latest feature film Tenet will be first shown in international cinemas before release in the USA can be considered. A release in 70 countries, including Australia, the United Kingdom, and Germany, is planned for August 26. As we already suspected, Tenet will then be released in the USA on September 3rd. This is intended to send out a signal to the world that, if necessary, the continuity of release dates will be waived and that a pragmatic decision will be made depending on the health situation in the country, which is why the USA will be the loser in this regard. By the way, there's no release in China, because the country prohibits the screening of films longer than 2 hours. So Tenet, with its 2 hours and 20 minutes, is out for now. If the Warner Brothers approach succeeds, we can well imagine that the same tactic will also be applied to other releases in the future. With the first season of The Witcher, Netflix was able to impress fans and critics around the globe. After the animated film Nightmare of the Wolf was already announced, fans can now look forward to further additions to The Witcher universe. The new live-action series will be called Blood Origin and will include a total of 6 episodes. The content will be a story set 1200 years before the main plot and will deal with the decline of the 11 civilizations. The so-called sphere conjunction is also supposed to play a major role. This is a special event in which several parallel universes met and merged into the world in which the plot of The Witcher main series also takes place. Only through this conjunction of spheres, the humans are supposed to have gained magical abilities, which is why the first Witchers were formed. Responsible for the 6-part series are the 2 producers Declan Ibarra and Lauren Schmidt-Hisrich, who are also involved in the main series. Andrzej Sapkowski, the author of the Witcher novels, is also on board and will be responsible for the content. Unfortunately, there's no fixed start date at the moment, but there are many indicators that Blood Origin will be released between the 2nd and 3rd season, which means a release date in late 2021 or early 2022 is likely. On the 20th of September this year, the annual Emmy Awards ceremony will take place to honor various television formats. A few days ago, the circle of favorites was further reduced as the nominations now have been officially confirmed. One streaming provider stands out at the top of the list all by itself, namely Netflix. The Californian company has a total of 160 nominations and is therefore undoubtedly throwing HBO off the throne with its 107 nominations. The brand new streaming service Disney Plus can also be happy. Although it can't compete with the first two providers in terms of the 15 nominations, Disney Plus has achieved something else that is unique. In its first year, The Mandalorian was nominated as Best Drama Series. The series with most nominations again comes from HBO. Watchmen can count 26 nominations, including Best Miniseries and Best Actor in a Leading Role. Immediately following with 20 nominations comes the Amazon series The Marvelous Mrs. Maisel, which already received the same number of nominations last year.